Here. We're excited for the start of the 2016 season. This team has gone through some good times together, but I want to open this up so I don't get questioned a lot by this. Yes, it is true. Josh Dobbs has been working out with our guys. He's a fabulous young man. I've known Josh since he's been here. He has a baseball background coming out of high school. I'm truly understand where his commitment lies to this university, and Coach Jones and myself and Josh have been in constant communication about any affiliation that he may or may not have with this program, and that's where I'm going to leave that for now.
Before we get into your team, how much has he been working out, and is this something that will legitimately move forward that he'll continue to do, or has this been something that he's kind of getting a baseball fix and you're not counting on it beyond?
Again, I'm just going to say Josh Dobbs has worked out 2 times with our team. It's been very minimal. He's actually under the weather right now. That's what it is. He's working out. He under the supervision of this coaching staff and with the blessing of Coach Jones that he'd be able to do it.
But in terms of whether he actually might play on the team, that's
still... I want to talk about this team. I love Josh Dobbs, but I want to talk about this team because I think it's unfair for the 34 other guys that have worn this uniform or have worked out in this uniform that have made a strong commitment to this program and what our goals are this year. I think it's unfair to them.
You mentioned ups and downs with this team, been through a lot. What do you like about the chemistry of this team moving into this season?
Well, Brent, I'll say this. To this point, they've shown they're a team, and that's important. We've done a lot with the Navy SEALs early on. I think that was something that I'll look back and really be happy that we did. It kind of brought a unity and a toughness to us, something that I think maybe we have lacked in the past. I don't feel there's any entitlement with this group. We just had a wonderful talk the other day from Luke Hochafer that came in and kind of talked about the Royals and what kind of team they were about and how they held each other accountable. These guys continue to hear the same thing, and I think it's going deep in their minds. We have some guys that obviously have some potential, and I think we have some great pieces to go along with it. But the competitiveness that I've seen with this group, whether it's in the weight room, whether it's in the cages, whether it's been during the fall, whether it's in their team room when they're playing ping pong or pool, has been really different, and I like what I've seen.
What do you see as the strength of the team right now, and where do you need to most work heading into the preseason?
Well, I'll say this. Now being the start of my fifth season, by far, no doubt about it, this is probably the deepest on paper pitching staff that we've had. We have great right-left combinations. I feel like we're going to be able to run a pitching staff that has 4 true starters, have 3 or 4 guys at the end of the game, end up being a closer, setup guys and all that, and guys that are developing right now that could end up pushing guys in the weekend towards the end of the year. I feel really strongly about our pitching staff. Obviously, the obvious is Nick Senzel is one of the best players in the country. That'll be in the middle of our lineup each and every day. Now it's finding the pieces to put around Nick, to protect Nick. And I'm expecting guys like Vincent Jackson and Jeff Moberg and Derek Lance, guys that have been seniors in this program, have been in this program so long, that are finally getting their turn and they're deserving of their turn. I anticipate those guys being the great pieces to put together for this puzzle.
What does it mean to have a player like Senzel coming back? I mean, how helpful is that?
Well, I over the course of my career and seeing other teams around the country, I think anytime you see a team that excels, they always have that superstar. Mm-hmm. And I think on the field, from the position player standpoint, Nick is that guy. He's getting all the accolades. He's well-deserving of that. But I think for us to be successful, it can't just all be about Nick. And that's not coming from Nick. That's coming from me. Nick can't win or lose every game for us. Okay, we're gonna need contributions from many other people that will allow him to be successful and allow our team to be successful. And that's what I'm excited about this group is, I, again, another thing that's a first time for me. I don't think I've ever had 8 seniors on a roster. And now when I say eight seniors, that's not just eight guys that are going to graduate at the end of the year. I'm talking about eight guys that are going to be make contributions to this team. And that's a big difference. When you have eight guys that are seniors that may not make contributions, sometimes that could cause problems in the clubhouse. But we have eight guys that are going to play pivotal roles in the success of this team.
The coaching staff changes you made, how will that affect y'all's philosophy on the field? Do you expect any, what kind of differences do you expect in terms of strategy, that type of thing, or will there be any?
We're playing baseball, and I know there's different ways to skin the cat, so to speak. We have made some changes in regards to our development process, in regards maybe philosophy, but it's not like someone's going to come out and say, boy, that's a whole different program they're running now. I've been taught a certain way. We've made some changes. I think the changes are for the good in regards to some philosophy. Now we'll just see how it plays out with the team. I think as a whole, you know, what's really important is the comfort of your team, of where they feel like they are. And that's, I feel this team has a little bit of confidence, like I hope they would, on what we're seeing as we go forward.
You talked about changes in philosophical development a little bit earlier, I guess last year, about kind of making it a little bit more like a pro club, a little bit, making it more about sort of individual fundamental development. How has that actually sort of manifested so far?
Well, I don't know if I'd go back and retract that I said like a pro club. I would say we're developing more individually. And I guess if you want to say from a professional standpoint, that's what they do. Our practices have been changed a little bit, that we're not as much into doing the team aspect stuff of the bunt defenses and the first and thirds. We're more into the technique of what they do at their position. And instead of doing a lot of bunt defenses, pitchers and infielders are doing more technique work. So when we do get a bunt defense, they are good at that. But I think our players have responded well to that. I think practices are exciting for them. They're not monotonous, even though we're in a sport where it's very repetitive in everything you do. I think each day has been, each day of practices in the fall, we've had full energy, and I think our guys are excited about what we're bringing to the table each and every day.
How wide open are things just from a roster lineup standpoint at this point, just going into the beginning of practice?
Well, you know, as coaches, we sit up there every day and talk, and obviously we have to make decisions based off of our past experiences and knowledge. I think that's a good question, because I think that's one of the reasons where the competitiveness has come with this team, is because in the past we've had guys that solidified at positions, and guys were trying to find what their niche was going to be, maybe in what backup role. I think guys have come in this year and realized that there was a lot of spots opened, and I think that's allowed guys to show up every day to work, whether it's when we're scheduled to go to work or practice or early, because they want to do everything they can to earn that spot that they see is wide open. I think right now we have an inter-squad game in our first scrimmage today. We've kind of mixed the lineups up because we want to balance out maybe our top 10 hitters getting the most at bats. So they may be hitting in the order, not where they will during the season, because we're trying to maximize their at bats in an inter-squad game. But I think as a coaching staff, we're still wide open, but I think there's some spots that I feel definitely have been solidified, and now it's going to be starting the season and seeing how they go from there.
A little more than 3 weeks before the start of the season, how excited are you to be getting this team on the field ready for 2016?
Well, my excitement is, my fear is the fact that we're 3 weeks away, and we have a lot of things to still do, and we'll always have things to do even throughout the season. My excitement is we get to be around these guys 6 days a week now, at least for 4 hours a day on some occasions. This is a fun group to be around. It is a really fun group to be around. I'm not saying it's a perfect world, but these guys like working together. We have fun working together, and we know we're going to have some challenges ahead of us, but I'm excited to go through those challenges with this group, because they've shown some resiliency, and I like what I've seen. So I'm really excited about where we're starting.
Is everybody healthy, and is there anybody from a pitching standpoint that you have to limit or anything like that? Is everybody...
I woke up a little sore throat this morning, but besides that, everyone's healthy. Everyone's healthy, and that's a good thing. Our guys did a fabulous job. I tell teams all the time that success and championships are won in November and December, when we can't be around our guys, when they're going through finals in their first semester, and staying in shape when they go home for the holidays to see their family. And I think this team did a fabulous job of getting stronger, getting faster, and coming back in baseball shape when we got back together on January 15th.
Dave, how much pressure do you feel in this season going in with your contract situation?
I don't feel any pressure at all. I'm working in the greatest university I could be at. I have no regrets where I'm at, and I have no pressure at all because there's only so much I can control, and I can control guiding this team and the young men that we have in this program to better things. So if that's all I control, I'm not going to worry about anything else. I'm proud to wear the uniform. I'm proud to be part of this university, and my goal is to end my career at this university.
As far as developing a rotation, developing a lineup, do you kind of have a timetable for when you want to have some of that stuff done? Basically, you're obviously type on in 3 weeks.
Well, yeah, you're right. What my plan is, no matter where we're at that time, is I'm thinking about running a stack rotation, piggyback the first weekend. Our guys will only be in 4 innings, maybe 5 innings shape, the starters. I feel we have a luxury of having 6 starters to choose from right now. Mm-hmm. So what I probably do is piggyback Friday, Saturday, and Sunday when we're down in Chattanooga and allow a starter to go 3 or 4, allow the other starter to go 3 or 4, and then have the bullpen guys to come in. That allows us to get 7, 8, 9 guys' feet wet as we go to the next weekend out when we go to Arizona and know a little bit more. And I have the luxury of doing that because we don't play a midweek game the following week. Right. So I'm able to get some guys in and not have to worry about winning a game on a Tuesday. So we have some good choices, though. We have some good choices. And what it's all going to come down to is where it, how guys stack up on how it's going to be the best for the team. Mm-hmm. And Zach Warren had a fabulous summer, had a fabulous fall. I think Hunter Martin went back to his old ways of his freshman year when he had a good campaign for us. Kyle Serrano really struggled in the fall, but over the last 3-4 weeks, he's got back to being a dude again, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. Andy Cox, I say this all the time, Andy Cox's success is pretty obvious. It's just a matter of keeping him healthy. I've talked about Hunter Martin, and Eric Freeman has been a guy that really has stepped up in the fall. Big Red was one of our better guys in the fall, and only through 1 inning last year, I've seen a true maturity process with him. I don't know if you could find a better Vol in him for how active he is in not just baseball stuff, but in a lot of stuff. We have good options. I mean, we do, and I'm excited about some of the options that we have, and it's a continuous competition amongst those guys. Like today, Zach Warren is going up against Kyle Serrano. Okay, they both want to be Friday guys, and I want them both to be Friday guys. Mm-hmm. So they get the matchup today. Most likely one will be a Friday guy and one will be a Saturday guy. That's a good problem to have. And so we have a plan in our mind, but I think the players are the ones that end up telling the whole story. I mean, by when it's all said and done, they're the ones that make the lineup out in regards to what they do.
Right. So there's 6, I guess, are Warren, Freeman, Serrano,
Martin, Cox, and Stephen Kane.
Stephen Kane.
Those are the 6 guys right now that I'd say are, and there's other guys too.
Right.
I got a young guy named Daniel Vasquez, Alex Harper-Cook at Maryville. Those are guys, freshmen, that are going to be good pitchers in this program that we're going to develop slowly through maybe midweek games and all that, but kind of like the Zach Warrens last year. I think part of Zach Warren's lack of development throughout to later in the years was the weather we had last year.
Right.
He missed a lot of starts because of weather. Mm-hmm. I'm hoping that's not the case for some of these other guys. So we've got some pitching, and as long as we could stay healthy, I'm excited where we are on the bump.